Hello, everyone! It is indeed Friday, September 6th, in the year of our Lord, 2019. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always, working awesome, and frantic Friday, it's party time. I've had some awesome things happen today. I am stoked, I'm excited, I'm pumped up, and we are going to bring out some wild, up-tempo, epic, badass music for today. That's what we're going to do, okay? And, all kinds of variety, all wild and up-tempo, awesome stuff. And, I'm stoked. I just bought some beer today. Where did I get it, of course? Where's the best place to buy adult beverages in Abilene? That's not a brewery. Ha! I say that because, you know, we got my wicked awesome friends at Pepperdine Brewing Company. You know, I go there every Saturday, buy a few pints of beer, buy some other friends pints of beer. It's what I do. You pay it forward. But these guys right here, Final Liquors on the corner of the Buffalo Gap Road, you know, man, subscribe here in Abilene, New York, Texas. And it was so awesome today to see one of the fellow co-owners, Jim Cockfield, phenomenal, epic, badass, mamma jamma, and our former Real Man of the Day on here today, the lovely, gorgeous, amazing, wicked awesome Sam Valdez, and of course the lovely, sweet, calm, cool, collective Tracy. You three, ladies, awesome seeing you today. Final Liquors, corner of Buffalo Gap Road, Neil Mitchell, here in Abilene, New York, Texas. Best selection of adult beverages you're gonna find in Abilene. And also thank you to the guys, custom laser engraving, lots of it too. These guys are amazing. And they did it again, folks. And it would be a criminal if I didn't mention our other fellow co-owners, Chris and Stephanie May, fellow New Englanders, wicked awesome legends. And of course my good buddy David Gomez, a hard working badass icon who works over there. And of course, Chris and Stephanie Mays, wicked awesome son Nick. Nick May, awesome young man. He's going places. Well, they did it again, folks. These guys did it again. 3 years in a row now. And I can't thank them enough. And yes, they are military veterans, owned and operated. So yes, Sam and Tracy, you requested the hug of the day for the day. And that's Jason Momoa.
Yeah.
And, of course, the owner of Pappy's Local Brewing Company, 409 South Treadway here in Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas, where I am going to be at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. Good old Yeehaw, Texas time. Hey, it'll be 5 p.m. in Jolly Old England. It'll be time to drink. And if I get there early and were to drink early, I mean, I'm not going to do that. But if I were to, it's been done before. Then I'm on French time. Simple as that. It's always 5 p.m. somewhere in the world. Anyway, so you gotta be careful not to show that off because I don't want anybody trying to steal my pass. But I'm just going to show it right there. Abilene Beer Summit VIP pass, okay? Yup, Saturday, September 21st. VIP members get in at 1 o'clock instead of 2 o'clock. I will be there Saturday. Now, that's funny. Oh, yeah, Saturday, September 21st. Now, it's funny, at the end of the event, it says, see you on Saturday, you know, on September 22nd. Ha, no, that's Sunday. Yeah, so the event coordinators made a boo-boo on that, but it is what it is. So, yes, Philo Liquors, 3 years in a row, bought me a VIP pass for free. $125 gift from Philo Liquors. Folks, I brag about them all the time. You know why? Because they are the most wicked awesome place to buy adult beverages around. All right? So, folks, go there. I don't care if it's all the way across town. You can get anywhere in Abilene, Texas in 15 minutes, okay? I know I can. But anyway, so, Philo Liquors, I want to give you a big, big, big standing ovation. Love that, the salute. Oh, hell yeah! You know the reason why I'm not wearing the Philo Liquors shirt today? Is because I promised my good buddy Chuck Maston, who I've known since January 7th, 1992. We got to San Antonio, Texas. Lackland. That's right. Flight 120. And it was truly wicked awesome. Final Liquor. Big Cowbell
for doing what you do. I apologize for not buying as much beer as I normally do. I know I've been bringing the customers to you. I'm all about that. But I do help out at that brewery. And there are times where I do help can beer and go home with copious amounts of beer as well. So, you know. And don't worry there, Pappy Slocum Brewing Company people. Because you're all getting big shout-outs too. Especially you, Jeff Bell. Because our babe of the day is Olivia Munn. And it's funny because I was talking to our friends at Philo today. Do you realize the two ladies, Sam and Tracy, were well familiar with Olivia Munn? Jim Cockfield was not familiar with Olivia Munn. Jim? Dude? Don't worry, Sam educated you on who she is. And my good buddy Jeff Bell, the primary big legend over at Pappy Slocum Brewing Company, came along with Yo, Richie! Richie Wagoner. And, of course, Brian Kokenauer, known as Coke. Awesome guys right there, the three owners. And, of course, you got a couple legends that work there as well. The incredible Travis Eason, who not only works at Pappy Slocum, but he also is a tattoo artist. And I'm telling you, folks, if you want to get a tattoo, and there's a lot of people that get tattoos, this guy right here is the real deal Holyfield. If you don't believe me, go to Pappy Slocum. He's got a book with his tattoos and his work. He's also got his tattoo page on Facebook. You can go check him out on Instagram right there. Got his email address. He's got a website. Go check out his work. The guy is epic and bad freaking ass. Yes, he is. All right, I need beer and I need more music. So, yes, picked up some beer. I ended up buying $66 worth of beer over at Philo Liquors. I mean, hey, got to pay it forward. I've got over 140 beers under the spare bed. And, you know, I got a fridge full of beer on top of that. Well, I had to buy more. So every time I go there, Tracy always grabs me a box. God bless you, girl. All right. Sam Valdez, you and I, this is our baby right here. Founders Breakfast Stout, my personal all-time favorite beer I think I've ever had in my entire life. Grand Rapids, Michigan. It's a double chocolate coffee oatmeal stout. It sits in a good, healthy 8.3% alcohol by volume. Grand Rapids, Michigan, the Mitten State. This stuff was just bottled May 28th. And this stuff, it truly is a meal in a beer consumption apparatus. Prop beer running apparatus. Prop technique. Here we go. And, of course, as always, hey, gotta represent Pappy Slocum Brewing Company. I mean, I got a lot of their beer glasses, so. 45 grand, I'm ready to beer. So I'm sitting up, asking over the keyboard. I told him, it's that damn good. I haven't supposed to drop yet. Never have, never will. Good God, I love this here beer. I hope no parts of my show get muted. I've done quite well recording and uploading. I haven't had any music issues. So, yeah. Let's do this. Let's get a picture of this here beer real quick. Because that's the right thing to do, baby. Ah, yeah. Try to get it with the picture of the, trying to get it with a picture of the logo. Can't do it. Trying to get a picture with the logo, the Vint Rest Garage logo, my buddy Chuck Mastin, his business, his shirt, awesome stuff. Trying the best I can. Well, like we always say, good enough for government work, right? Yeah. All right. So there we go. And that will go on Untappd. Great app for logging in beers. This stuff is a magnificent five-star epic badass beer. Cheers, beers, all you. Proceed in Germany. Goodbye, Sage Ben. As we love to say at Pappy Slocum, who's your pappy? Ah! Yes, folks, I know I love stripper dust. Good God, I love my stripper dust, okay? I'm sorry, Pappies. You guys know this is my personal all-time favorite beer. You know it is. And hey, don't worry, because even though we're at Pappy Slocum, they don't always drink Pappy Slocum beer. Come on now. In fact, none of the three owners even like stripper dust. They brew what sells, not what they personally want. Okay? That's how you run a business. Now, granted, of course, they make small batches of some of their favorite stuff, too, as they should. It's the right thing to do. I know I would. All right, here we go. A Run for Life, Dick Dale and the Deltones, 1962. He did a remake a year later called The Wedge. I'm going to play both versions because they're both fantastic, and you'll hear how similar they are. I prefer this version over the other one myself, but they're both out freaking standing. All right. Now, we got birthday shout-outs galore. We got additional shout-outs. And I want to mention the Bass Guy Show real quick. The Bass Guy Show. You guys are going to be getting shout-outs. In fact, let's just go ahead and do it now. Dan Alexander, awesome call-in today. He plays a big-ass double bass. Obviously, Jack Casey, he's the bass guy, phenomenal musician, and I'm going to give you a bit more of a shout out to them. I'll play one of your songs that you played yourself, and thank you for the usage of your music. You're a very accomplished one-man band, Jack Casey, bass guy. I love your buddy, Shaka. Gajen Mallory, total sweetheart. Frankie McDonald, he's up in Sydney, Nova Scotia, Canada. I'm praying for your buddy. And I know you being a weather that you'll be safe. You know what to do. Frankie McDonald actually predicted Hurricane Dorian to hit Nova Scotia. Predicted it well over a week ago. This young man is a damn genius. Sloppy, unfocused, total sweetheart. She is amazing. One of the admins. Jen's an admin. I'm an admin of the Bass Guy Show. It's Billy today. He's an admin. He is a New York Yankees fan. But he's so freaking wicked awesome. I love the man to death. Hey, I like turtles too. It's Billy D, a legend. He's a New Yorker. He should be a Yankees fan. I'm an original asshole. Of course I should be a Boston Red Sox fan. Van Goat, Scott Van Goat, out of Connecticut. Oh, yeah. Or is it, I always forget if Billy's from Connecticut and Scott's from freaking New York. I think Van Goat's from Connecticut and Billy D's from New York. And I'm from Massachusetts. You know, we got a nice Northeast connection there. And, of course, Jack Casey near Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Eh? You know what I'm saying? Eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada indeed. Hey, you got to get some loving neighbors up north. And I do it all bears on the day every single day of the week. Fucking A. Yeah, so I promised Dan Alexander I'd give him a shout out. He wants a shout out. You got to shout out Dan Alexander. He's not on the old Facebook. He says, I need to dump Facebook. I'm like, bro, I can't do that. I explained why. He's like, okay, I can see that. That makes sense. Hey, you know, a lot of friends on Facebook. You know, it's my best way of keeping in touch with everybody. You know, that's what I do. Trying to think who else. We had Osvaldo on there earlier today. So Osvaldo and John, a couple guys that I'm familiar with Osvaldo. I'm not overly familiar with John. I believe both guys are friends of Frankie, if I'm not mistaken. Osvaldo might be a friend of the bass guy. I can't remember, but those guys are very cool. It's just a show, a variety show, a lot of goofiness, a lot of fun. The bass guy, Jack Casey, is a one-man band. Let me play The Wedge real quick, and then I'm going to play a song by my good friend, Jack Casey, the Bass Guy Show. He's happy that I'm going to do it. I'm happy to do it. And, all right, here you go, The Wedge, 1963. Tough to say which version is better. Personally, I think a Run for Life, the original version, is better, but that's my opinion. This one sounds a little wetter, if you will. They're both great, great songs. Yeah, baby! don't worry. We'll get to the eye candy too, I promise you. Fantastic Garage, my man Chuck Mastin. Thank you so much for the three free t-shirts.
I love the drumming on this better version.
He's up in Michigan. Something sick, Chuck. Dude, you need Founders in your life. I'm sure you've had it. Highly recommend. Probably one of the best breweries in the entire United States. I brought out, and this is no disrespect to my friends at Happy Slogan, but I have told you guys this. I do feel Martin House might have the best beers in all of Texas. They are the Dogfish Head of Texas. You need them in very different beers. In honor of Cool Runnings! Feel the rhythm, feel the break, get on up and fuck like that. Cool Runnings! Peace be that journey. Look at this motherfucker, will ya? Martin House Brewing Company, Fort Worth, Texas. Hazy Jamaican Coconut IPA with coconut. 10% by volume. The numbers don't lie, people. And then at the end of my show, when I probably will have a buzz, I've never had this one either. I picked this up over Fire Liquors as well. Martin House Pina Colada. Coconut cream ale with pineapple. I'm thinking of you, Stephanie Flores, and good old fucking A. Danae. And Danae, Danae, and Steph, you two lovely goddesses. I'm drinking this beer in honor of the two of you, and I will be happy to give you one as a gift from me to you because you're very dear friends of mine and fellow co-workers, and I'm going to drink this one in the honor of you two lovely ladies while I'm showing off the baby today that I know you two are going to be loving. Yeah, I know I will too. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Hi. So, we talked about the bass guy, Jack Casey. And here it is. He played it on his show today. And ironically enough, this album was actually, he released this album September 9th, 2014. So, bass guy, I want you to play a song from this album on your show Monday. And by the way, you and I are playing dual cowbells on the air. A U.S.-Canadian cross-country cowbelling, baby. Cross-country cowbelling. That was so freaking wicked awesome. Every time I call in from now on, every Friday, when you do the call-ins, I'm doing cowbells with you, bro. You know, Jen was right. I guess I can play some musical instruments. I did all right with that. Oh, that was fun. That was epic. That freaking rocked, brother. All right. So here you go. Impressions. Originally recorded by John Coltrane in 1961. This is a badass song. I really love the rendition that Barry Turner and Jack Casey give on this one. Barry Turner is, of course, one of Jack Casey's good friends. And I don't play enough jazz on my shows. And I messaged you earlier today, bass guy, and I said, you know what, I gotta start incorporating more jazz into my shows. So that is something that I will do. I'm gonna do that. Because it's the right thing to do. Beautiful song. Yeah. I'm just looking through and prepping for my next song real quick. Just chilling like a villain, chilling like a villain. To you, bass guy, and your wicked awesome show, let me give you a standing ovation, brother. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah. Cowbell, more cowbell. Awesome freaking song right here, folks. Awesome song. No doubt about it. Alright. We got birthday shoutouts to give. I think I've already given shoutouts to everybody I had lined up for additional shoutouts. I normally give the birthday shout-outs first, but today it was all about the additional shout-outs, so very important. And Jeff Bell, don't worry, buddy. Jeff Bell, you know what I always like to say, right? Good things come to the, in more ways than one, to those who wait. First of all, my friends of Philo Liquors, especially the ladies. There's your hunk of the day right there, Jason Momoa. You ladies and you men that love the men love this guy, Jason Momoa, Aquaman. Tracy requested him, so did Sam. I say we're gonna make it happen, we're gonna unleash the beast. Your hunk of the day, Jason Momoa. Now, our babe of the day. For one of the owners of Pappy Social Brew Company, 49 South Tweedway, here in Abilene. The lovely, incredible, insanely hot, wicked awesome Olivia Munn. I find that picture fucking sexy. Those panties are sexy too. Oh my god. Shaven, not stirred. I'd stir it with my tongue. If I was single, of course. Just said, yes, base guy, I belong in the bad corner. And I'm proud of that. I need to comment in the bad corner just to do it. So your babe of the day. Oh! There you go, bass guy. She's dancing for you, big man. Jeff Bell. She's on her knees for you, buddy. Now I know you're a good, loyal man and happily taken. But, Olivia Munn. She thinks you're a hot Jeff. Yeah. Well, Jeff is a former Rear Hunk of the Day on Bears Holiday, by the way, in case you were wondering. Having a lovely guy, just better have Margie. Yeah, baby. So there you go. We got birthday shout-outs. We got a whole bunch of them to do. A big happy birthday shout-out to a former Rear Hunk of the Day on Bears Holiday. Originally from Maine. Oh, yeah. Otherwise known as Southern Quebec, Canada. Yeah. My man, John Tyler. The man has traveled the world. He's living in Las Vegas, Nevada at the moment. With his lovely gorgeous better half, Jen. Jennifer Tyler, John and Jennifer Tyler. Love that couple so much. I was honored, proud, privileged, and pleasured to officiate their wedding ceremony. That's right, yours truly, love, Dr. Reverend Dr. B. I've been a legally ordained minister since June 25th, 2005. I've officiated over 24 weddings, and I'm proud and honored to do it. And I do it for free. Yes, I do. I do not charge to officiate wedding ceremonies. Why? I do it out of the goodness of my heart, people. You always pay it forward. And you know that's what I'm talking about. And I'll drink to that, and you all should too. Jordan Tyler, we're not done talking about you yet. All right. Time for more music. Yeah, baby. Rock a while, 1949, Gory Carter. How about some rhythm and blues, baby? Yeah, I love me some rhythm and blues. No, I do. This 70-year-old song is badass, and the guitar on this is doing the stuff of legends. Oh, freaking yeah, baby! Jordan Tyler, brother, I am so proud of you and your progress in your job career. You have no idea. You're a badass age ranger, dead star, because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. I know you ain't no rump ranger. Jennifer, I know you're going to spoil Jordan. Rod, I know he's away right now, getting more education, becoming an even better leader of men, women, and men. And Jordan Tyler, our former Rail Hunk of the Day, our Arizona Day. Happy birthday to you, brother. Hope you have an awesome day. Hey, you sell me well and enjoy. And a big cheers, beers. And if you pass through Abilene, you better message me, because I want to give you some beer. I know what you can't get. You can't get Pappy Slocum Stripper Dust in Las Vegas, Nevada. However, you can get it from the Love Doctor. You can get it from Philo Liquors. You can get it anywhere around Abilene. So yeah, Jordan, how are your birthday to you, brother? Hope you're working on some days, so we're all enjoying a big chance of beer this evening, buddy. And Jordan, for the exact same birthday year as you is my good friend, Brittany Rose. I met Brittany over at that wicked awesome place. That's right. Ben and Brittany Rose, an incredible couple. Very dear friends of mine. Haven't seen you guys in a while, have I? I think we met at Pappy. We may have been down the road at 720 China Street. Good old Sock Dollar Brewing Company, 720 China Street here in Abilene, yeah, Texas. Another great brewery to go check out, folks. Very dear friends of mine over there. And, obviously, my loyalty is Pappy's. That's my place. But it doesn't mean you can't go visit other places, okay? I mean, come on. Don't be a disrespectful douchebag. I mean, the owners visit each other, talk to each other all the time. It's all about making the city of Abilene and the community better. Options, baby, options. Not trying to bring each other down. No, we're trying to build up. Independent craft brewers. And ironically enough, now see, this one doesn't have. I just realized something that's very ironic. I always thought this was an independent craft beer. See, I'll show you something. Well, this one doesn't have it either. That's weird. I always thought they were, This is what I'm looking for, people. See this right here? That. Independent craft beer. Brewers Association, independent craft, certified Brewers Association, independent craft is what that is. That's what I'm all about seeing on beer cans. Obviously, Canadian beer is a little different. They don't have that. But, yep. Oh, shit. You know, I always thought there was on more beers. Very interesting. Starting to learn something new today. Yeah, I know. I got some empties in the recording studio. I got to pick them up. I'll be picking them up right after the show, and then I got to go to bed. I have to wake up for work 6 hours from right now. 5.05 p.m. here in Yeehaw, Texas. Hey, I can drink beer. It's always 5 p.m. somewhere in the world. I'm a Massachusetts guy, so I was on 5 p.m. earlier, all right? That's why I started. I drink whatever the fuck I want, damn it. I don't give a shit what time it is. If I want a beer, I'm drinking, damn it. As long as I ain't working, I mean, come on. And if I'm driving, I'm going to be careful. I, Big Sandy, Bobby Roberts, 1958. Here's some wild rockabilly for you. Oh, God, I love this.
Well,
Brittany Rose, happy birthday to you, man, with my friend. You and John Woody, I say birthday to you, two very dear friends of mine. And you guys are awesome. Happy birthday, hope you all have a day, so we will enjoy the big chance of beer. See ya. My dear friend, Jenny Lynn Austin. I've known Jen for over 21 years now. I lied. I met you 20 years ago. September 25th, 1999. The day that my brother and his wife got married. Yeah. That's right. Jen Austin. The bride and the bride from Massachusetts. A total sweetheart, I believe. You're very dear friend of mine. I love you, girl. Happy birthday to you, girl. I hope you're doing marvelous. I hope you're living up. I hope you're having fun. I hope you're having a good day. I love you, Jen. And hey, to you, my dear. Even though you are a New York Yankees fan from Massachusetts, which boggles my freaking mind, I still love you anyway, sweetheart. To you, Jen, a big cheers and beer to you, my dear.
Yeah, baby.
How about my good friend Jack? Otherwise, she's known as Fickle Pickle. Her nickname is Fickle Pickle. Jack Payhurst. I just met her recently.
Over to that place! Time to show the Brewing Company! Yeah! I meet so many awesome people there! Every Saturday, I meet new friends! It's incredible! You want to meet new awesome people? Well, maybe they're not new, maybe they're older. They're new to you. You want to meet great people? I'm dead serious about this, folks. I am dead freaking serious about this. You want to meet great people? Saturdays, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. That's the place to be. Nothing but great people. You can bring your kids, bring your dogs, and there's always a great food truck. Case in point, my good buddy Jody Murillo, fellow Masonic Brother Cruise and Cafe, him and his lovely, gorgeous hostess with the mostest, Sierra Juliana Mesta. That roll off the tongue real nice. Yeah, she's a hottie. Jody and Sierra are going to be a future Real Hunk and Real Baby of the Day on Baron Song of the Day. And no offense, Jody, but I'm looking more forward to featuring Sierra than I am featuring you. You know why? Because, hey, I'm a lesbian trapped in a man's body. That's why. I'm a man. I have a dick. And you know what? Pussy's my friend. Yeah, baby. Shit, I'll drink to that. Fuck it, I'm gonna slam it home. Why not? That beer goes down like a good woman, I'm telling you. Alright. If these are brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? No offense there, base guy. I know you're a Montreal Canadiens fan. And you know what? You should be a Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? But here's the problem, brother. Here's the problem. I'm a Boston Bruins fan. I'm a Boston Celtics fan. I'm a New England Patriots fan. I'm a Boston Red Sox fan. I am all things masterful and damn proud of it. And the Montreal Canadiens, from 1948 to 1976, every time the Canadiens faced the Bruins in the playoffs, the fucking Canadiens knocked us out of the playoffs. You know why we won the cup in 1970 and 72? Because we didn't have to face the bloody freaking Montreal Canadiens, eh? So yeah. Oh, Canada indeed. But I love you, base guy. I do. No fear, as you always say. Base guy loves you, no fear. What a love that to love you. Shaka! In your honor, brother. Aye! It's time for more beer! Hey, if I'm gonna drink Jamaican beer, I gotta play a little bit of Jamaican music at least. In fact, I'm going all out. Go big or go home, right? That's right, if God hates coward. So here we go. We put on the dreadlocks. Yaman! Did you know they actually don't say Yaman in Jamaica? They do not. It's a tourist thing. Now, in Kingston, the capital of Jamaica, tourist area, they do say Yaman now. Because the tourists freaking love it. But yeah, Jamaican folks do not say Yaman. They don't. A lot of people think they do, but they don't. But I'm going to bring out my all-time favorite Jamaican song ever, and we're going to bust out Peace Be the Journey. Mountain House Brewing Company's legendary hazy Jamaican IPA with coconut. Oh, 10% alcohol by volume. That's right. Double the strength of a normal beer. Holy mother of God. This is crazy. All right, so hold on a second. Come on. Proper warning apparatus. Proper technique. Here we go. All right. 45 degree angle, ready to be a substance apparatus. All right, keyboard. Come set, thing. Boot, husband. Drop yet. Never happened, never will. This stuff's 10%. I'm not going to be sober by the time I'm done. I know it. I just know. Because this stuff is double strength of a normal beer, and I can't wait to drink it. Never had it. Very excited for it. If you're going to drink a Jamaican beer, peace be the journey. Peace be the journey. I say it all the time. You guys know I've been saying it for years. Where did I get the saying from? Duh. Cool Runnings. That's right. Feel the rhythm. Feel the run. Get on up. It's bobsled time. Cool Runnings. Some people say you know they can't believe Jamaica, we have a bobsled team. Some people say you know they can't believe Jamaica, we have the bobsled team. We have the Owen DeRees, anyone junior, Yo Brenner and the man Sanka, the fastest of the fastest Jamaica sprinters. Respect to the man Herb Leitzer. Oh God, I love that movie. It's one of my all-time favorite movies.
It is so inspirational, people. I'm all about being inspired, and it is a very, very inspirational movie. Let's get a picture of this real quick. Come on. Here we go. Here you go, y'all. Y'all, as they say in Texas. Yeah. All right. Time to put this down the gullet. We're going to drink Jamaican beer, Jamaican style beer, and we're going to drink, well, Jamaican honored. Honored for the Jamaicans. The year of Jamaican independence. Jamaica became independent August 6, 1962, the day after Patrick Ewing was born. Patrick Ewing, of course, New York Knicks legend, badass icon, Hall of Famer, who sadly never did get a championship. I watched him get drafted number one overall in 1985 NBA draft while I was at my grandparents' house. We watched him get drafted out of Georgetown University. Patrick Ewing, 7 foot tall, badass beast, center. That guy, class act, and a phenomenal basketball player. And he was from Kingston, Jamaica. How about that? So he lived one day under British rule before Jamaica became independent. I'll never grow old. Toots and the Maytals. August 6, 1960. Well, not this ain't from August 6, 62, but I know it is from 1962. And I'm 46 years old, and I'll never grow old either. Love this song. Here you go. Yeah. Cheers to beers, all you pro Saint Jimmy Kapai, Saint Japan. Uh-oh. Yeah. Red Sox hat. I know it's going to make my boy Billy D sick. But Billy D, I like turtles too. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Heroes and a Half Show. Turtle power. Ha! Alright! I think we need to bring out another great instrumental. Here's a white guy with a saxophone. The Whip! Gilbert Hall! This guy fucking nuts. So here you go. Gilbert Hall, the Whip, 1954. Here you go, brothers and sisters and legends. Hey! Happy birthday to Jack Hayhurst, Fickle Pickle. Hey, I hope you all enjoy today. So you all enjoy. Good to make cheese and beer to you. Hey! Go to Baptist Local Brewing Company tomorrow. I'll be there. Say, hey, you owe me a pint. You owe me a birthday pint, I'm gonna buy you a pint for me, for your birthday, because you're wicked awesome. This is what I do, this is a tradition of mine that I do now. Everybody has a birthday during the week. I tell them, I will buy you a birthday pint on Saturday. That's my way of paying it forward for you.
Happy birthday to my good friend Jeff Day!
A great man with great first names, just like my father Jeff, Jeff Baker, of course. To my good buddy Jeff Bell, of course, time's over. A lot of great Jeffs out there, people. And Jeff Day is one of them. Jeff Day!
Okay, hey, happy birthday to you! I believe I met you!
I can't remember where I met you. I heard you a bit.
But dude, Jeff! What's going on with you?
He's an Emily legend, icon.
You're all in Texas!
Oh, I know something wrong with him, I said, I'm safe.
Jeff Day! Happy birthday to you, brother!
Hope you love it, hope you have fun, hope you have a weight-loss day. And you so very well enjoying a big cheers meeting to you, buddy. Again, folks, not to be messed with. 10% alcohol, my boy.
Oh my god, that's wicked strong.
You can taste some alcohol in here.
This is a very strong IPA.
It's delicious, though.
I'm gonna give it a,
Now, personal preference would call it a 4.25. Based on style and what they shoot for. There's a very slight coconut in here. You know what, we'll leave it at 4.25. Because the coconut isn't very noticeable. There's a nice slight sweetness on the finish. Let me do an uninterrupted quick taste test. I'm trying to become a better beer judge. And Jeff, you know what I'm talking about. You know, I got a good beer palate. Maybe someday I will become a certified beer judge here in Abilene, Texas. There's only one, my good buddy Tom Bradley. And he thinks I need to become a certified beer judge. That speaks volumes to me. Speaks a lot of volumes. Pappies, they have me check their beers. They want to see what I think of them. And I appreciate that. That I feel honored being able to test the beers and giving it good, honest feedback. They appreciate good, honest feedback. They want good, honest feedback. And I do my very best to try to be unbiased and help them. And, you know, if it sucks, I need to tell them that. The problem is, they don't brew shitty beer. So I can't tell them it sucks. That's not a problem. That's a good thing. Let me try this one more time. It's weird. It's like the back of the tongue, right about there, kind of gets that coconut. I can't explain it, but that's where I get it. I can get that sweetness. It's definitely strong. IPA fans would love it. If you're a big fan of juiciness, it's not as juicy as people like my good buddy Adam Alaguchi loves. There's so many different styles of IPAs out there. You know, it's just a matter of trying. I used to not like IPAs. I couldn't do it. About 3+ years ago, I'm like, nah. Now I'm getting to the point where I'm actually buying them. I'm buying them. And I'll tell you, they've grown on me. Now, I'm still a stout porter kind of guy. Always have been. Probably always will be. I hope I always will be because, good Lord. Gotta love that beer. All right. So, I feel like I want some gospel music. Get Your Soul Right, 1953. Fireside Gospel Singers. I love me some gospel music. I'm telling you, it makes you feel good. It's got a lot of talent.
Well, get your soul right in this world.
Yo, baby!
Get your soul right.
Got my soul right. Glory, hallelujah. Donald Hammer! There's another guy I met over at Pappy Summer Broke up here 4 nights up to Leo Devil, yeah, Texas. Donald Hammer! With one hammer, not two. Donald, you are a fucking hammer! Donald Hammer is one of the coolest cats, one of the coolest customers of that brewery. I know he's a busy guy, but Donald, I owe you a birthday pint, brother. I fucking love you because you're always a positive attitude. You're always loving life. You live life to the fullest. Darryl, you're like me, brother. It's a day after the
It's a wicked awesome day as long as you're alive to see it, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Donald Hammer, happy birthday to you, brother. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Sammy Rollins, joy. And I'll bank you, man, so you listen to that screaming way. I'm starting to sweat up in here. I'm sorry, I get pumped up. I want to say happy birthday to my man, Danny Rust. Danny Rust, a legend I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Yeehaw, Texas, although I know it's West Louisiana. Pretty much the same damn thing. Danny, happy birthday to you, bro. It'll be a little while. What's going on with you? How you doing, bud? Hope you're doing marvelous. Sorry, I'm mesmerized by this. I forgot how fucking awesome this song is. Only I would drop a freaking F-bomb during gospel music. Sorry, Danny. I'll get the rest of you in a moment. Feel in the spirit, baby. Feel the spirit. I can't help it. Woo, baby! Get your soul right! I'll put that down. Warm the soul, baby. That's what I'm talking about. You gotta live till you die. Right, bass guy? Right, Jeff Bell? Right, Philo Lickus? Right, Pappy Soul and Brewer Company? Right, bass guy show? You guys know that I'm all about living right. Positive attitudes. I'm telling you, when it's your time to go, it's your time to go. But by God, make every day down here on earth wicked awesome. And that's what I do. Get your soul right. Take care of people. And Donald Hammer. Oh, Danny Rust. Donald Hammer, you live right. I know you do. You're like me. We live right every day, baby. We have lots of fun living life to the fullest. Danny Rust, remember that, young man. Live life to the fullest. Ain't no point in bitching, you know? Hey, remember, all you gotta do, people, and this is what I talked to my good friend Dan Alexander about on the Bass Guy Show today. I said, hey, all you gotta do is you look at people bitching on Facebook, and there's a lot of bitching on Facebook, and you say, hey, thank God my life's a lot better than theirs, because obviously theirs fucking sucks. And you press on and live right. That's what I do. That's what I do, people. I enjoy life. I have fun living it. Even when shit goes bad, just remember, there's always a lot worse. Okay? I mean, you could be a New York Yankees fan. Ha! Sorry, Billy D. I had to go there. Yeah, brother. All right. Anyway, so Danny Rust, my good friend, young man, awesome guy, hard-working badass. Dude, happy birthday, buddy.
For the Bay Chaser Bears.
Wow, man. I would love to mellow out for a moment. But it is Frantic Friday, so I gotta keep it high octane all the way balls to the wall. Cause that's me. Go big or go home, right?
Got that right, Reverend Dr. B. You know what's up, brother. Yeah, baby.
Hi. So, what are we gonna play next? Ooh. I know what I'm gonna play. I just thought of it. How about some Chris Powell and his Five Blue Flames? Yeah. Because that is a good idea. I mean, we are drinking Jamaican beer, right? Well, this song's from 1962, or 52 rather. This song's from 1952. And the song's called I Come From Jamaica. Wow.
Almost came up with a prize on that one. Gross, I know.
Where the hell? Ah, there it is. 1952. OK Records. Ford-S6900. I come from Jamaica. 1952. Chris Powell and his Five Blue Flames. Wild, wild song. So here you go.
Blake Hedgepeth is a legend I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise, I'm not in Mexico.
Pretty much in that country. Blake!
What's up, brother? Happy birthday to you, buddy. How you doing? Hope you're doing marvelous.
You know I'm doing marvelous. Yeah, brother.
Blake Hedgepeth. This work when you're on a job site. Have a good buddy. Hope you have a wonderful day. Something well to enjoy. Big chance of fancy the big guy. Happy birthday to a longtime friend of mine in the mafia.
Was. Zoe Zarek. Zoe, Zoe, Zarek. C-Z-A-R-O-K.
Zoe, haven't heard me in a long time. But boy, did we play the mafia was together for a long time, didn't we?
You got that right. Yeah, baby.
And Zoe, happy birthday to you, my dear. And I hope y'all having fun. I hope you learned up. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day, Zoe. Let me learn from you. How you doing? Zoe will. And enjoy. And I'll bet you the beer to you, my dear. Happy birthday! I knew it growing up with Sarah Towns. Sarah Towns is an ageless wonder goddess. There's something about us people from my state island, Massachusetts. We don't age. Sarah, you're beautiful. You're gorgeous. I knew it growing up with Sarah Towns. Sarah Cicerelli.
I hope I pronounced that right.
Cicerelli. Cicerelli. My good Italian man. Sarah, I see what you got through. You know, Sarah, you're such an inspirational young lady. I'm very inspired by you. You know, you had a point, you were suffering illness, and you pressed on Drew. And that positive attitude of yours kept you living. And I'm so proud of you, Sarah. You are an epic badass and a fine, outstanding representative of the greatest island in the world, Martha's Vineyard. Sarah, happy birthday to you, my wonderful, wicked, awesome, and beautiful friend. And I hope you're having fun. I hope you're living it up. I hope you have a wicked, awesome day. You're an inspiration to all of us from the greatest island in the world. And a big cheers of beers to you, my dear. An original pride of Eggertown, Massachusetts. I got two more shout-outs for birthdays. And then we're done with the shout-outs for my people out there. And then we're going to get into the eye candy. The vehicle instrument pet hunk and baby today. Because we call him the Stormin' Mormon. A very dear friend of mine, originally out of Utah. That's right, Utah. Works with him in Joy Oak, England. We went to Bible camp together back in 2011. Marv Nelson, can you believe it's been 8.5 years since we were in Bible camp together? Wow! Marv Nelson is one of the coolest dudes you'll ever meet in your life. A great man, a great family man, a great Mormon out of Utah. I worked with him in Joy Oak, England. We went to Bible camp together. We found God, learned lots of scripture. He did not discover a lot of beer, adult beverages like I did, because he's a great man and very devout. But in your honor there, Marv Nelson, and Lord knows we tried to get you to swear so many times. I've never heard you swear in my entire life. God bless you, brother. We're going to play some gospel for you. I, John, saw the number. Okay? If this doesn't get you moving and grooving there, you walk a muscle with a head, Marv Nelson, I don't know what will. And Marv Nelson is a great man and a walk a muscle with a head. He's a brick shit house. Yeah! You know what I love about Marv the most, though? He would never judge anybody for the way they are. I mean, I got a foul mouth, all right? I'm from Massachusetts. Every four words is fuck, pretty much, okay? In New York, it's about one out of every three.
We're not as bad as New York, but we're pretty close. But anyway, he doesn't judge us for that. Judge not, lest ye be judged yourselves. Marv is a great man, and we'll play some gospel in his honor for his birthday. I, John, saw the number. 1960, the Fairfield Four. If this doesn't get you moving and grooving, you're dead. You're a corpse. Simple as that. I'm sorry. Marv Nelson, the Stormin' Mormon, you epic legend. Happy birthday to you, my brother, from another mother. I hope you're living up all my young fun. I hope you have a great awesome day. You rock, buddy. You celebrate well and enjoy. You badass kook-kook. Take care of the man to you, buddy. At this rate, it's gonna be a 4-year show. And I'm okay with that, because I'm not driving anywhere for a while. Final birthday shout out goes to a good friend of mine, who I know from that brewery right there, Babbage from the Brewing Company, 409 South Carolina Avenue, Texas. Not only that, we've drank together. Red Dot Brewing Company, 712 Conrad Hill Boulevard, Cisco, Texas. 45-minute drive away, well worth it. And we've also tried numerous times at Primal Brewing Company, 140 Market Street in Bear, Texas, which is about a 22-minute drive from Abilene. Randy Valdez, your birthday's tomorrow. Randy Valdez, I hope you're there tomorrow. Your birthday pint's on you, buddy. You are one of the Pabstone Brewing Company's absolute best customers. You bet your ass I'm buying you a beer, buddy. Why? Because you're like Smith's body. You're mad the old-fashioned way. Randy Valdez, a great man, a great family man, I know down here in Texas. Otherwise known as Eastern Mexico, pretty much the same state. Randy Valdez, you're a brick shithouse, you're a great guy, you're awesome, always a positive attitude. In your honor, I'm going to down the rest of this 10% beer, and I will have downed an 8.3% beer and a 10% beer within about 55 minutes. Okay? Fuck it. FDS of brain cells of an average Los Angeles Lakers fan. Yeah, pretty fucking empty, right? Okay, so we've two down. There ain't no way in hell I'm going to be able to have my favorite hunk of the day last for just one beer. As you all know, always got my Boston Red Sox fan zone chili box. Keep my beers freaking cold and complete with the ice pack and everything. Perfect for tailgating. That's right. And that ice pack's still nice and cold. Keep my beers freaking colder. So, we bring, before I play out this next song, we're going to bring out another Martin House Brewing Company beer. Pina Colada. Coconut cream ale with pineapple for you, Danae. For you, Steph. You two lovely goddesses. Who I think should be featured as future real babies of the day on my show. Absolutely. Yeah, because I know you two love pineapples. And I hope you love coconut too, because like the two of you ladies, like you two ladies, you're very sweet. Just like coconut. Yeah, baby. All right, this stuff's 5.4% alcohol by volume. Yeah, a lot lower in strength. It's still above average. A normal average beer is about 5%. A lot of people don't know that, but it's truth. T-R-O-O-F, truth. So, probably running apparatus pump technique, here we go. Another one I've never featured on my show. Never had it. 45 degree angle right, made something apparatus, right from keyboard, comes that damn good, haven't spoken drop yet, never have, never will. All right, Danae, Steph, I'll see you two lovely ladies tomorrow on the job site. Or, of course, by the time you watch the show, I will have already seen you. And we are going to take a quick picture. And then we are going to play another great song. Where did I put my phone? Did I really misplace my phone? Okay. Maybe I got... I'm such a man. My paper with my show notes. And what was underneath it? The phone. Well, shit on a shingle. What do you expect? I'm such a man. If something's put underneath something, I ain't finding it. What the fuck is this? Look at this. Come in for an interview by tomorrow. Hey, Ufret Rodriguez. Get the fuck out of here, you schlepper. Who the fuck are you? Wow, really? Oh, the spam you get sometimes is very entertaining. Come tomorrow for an interview. Well, tomorrow I'll be doing my job on the job site starting at 1:15 in the morning. And then after that, I'm going to go get my ears loaded because my flat top's not looking very, my flat top's looking substandard. And I gotta get my ears lowered. So where do I go? U.S. Hair. Look them up. U.S. Hair. Here at Abilene. Yeehaw, Texas. Best damn place to get your ears lowered. No question about it. In my opinion. They cut my flat top perfect. All four barbers. So me being the loyal guy that I am, I will never change barbers. No matter what. Even though there's a barber shop that actually has you drink beer while you're getting your ears lowered. And I know they do a great job. But U.S. Hair, all four barbers are perfect. And you don't, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, okay? I'm sorry, but I'm a loyal guy. I'm an old school guy. That's a pretty damn good picture, even though I'm an ugly motherfucker. That beard looks really nice. All right. What we need to do, I need to play a song from 1953 because our vehicle of the day is from 1953. So it's only fitting we do that. But however, our instrument of the day is from 1947. Our song, our instrument of the day comes from, oh hell. We're going to play Wynonie Harris. Blow Your Brains Out from 1947. Wynonie Harris, Mr. Bluesy was known as. This guy, epic, legendary. And he's our instrument of the day, and you'll see in a moment. So, hey, as we show off our vehicle of the day, 1953 Mercury Monterey. And we're going to play a song from 1953 in honor of that. We've already done a 1953 song. That's the 1953 Mercury Monterey. That's our vehicle of the day on Mercury Song Day. Burgundy.
Every time marches on, day looks pretty. Every time marches, marches. Now I want you to meet Tom Archer.
Tom Archer, Saxon Master. That's what you hear him playing the saxophone right now. Tom Archer, or known as Archer, A-R-C-H-I-A. Mr. Blues, Wynonie Harris's microphone.
You ain't heard nothing until you hold
instrument of the day. All birds on day.
He'll blow a lot of horn. Yes, now what you bet? Homer!
Hey, bass guy! I know you can play harmonica. I know you can play the drums. I know you play the bass guitar extremely well. I know you play keyboard as well. Jack Casey, bass guy, you're a hard one-man band. Can you play the saxophone? I'd love to hear it if you could. That'll make you play horn. Our pet of the day, Olivia Munn's doggy. Arf! I'll drink to that. Make your dog a lucky dog today. And that lucky dog is on her boobies. That's a lucky dog right there.
Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
She's with his former, that's a former pet of the day, Jason Momoa's dog. Former, his favorite day, Jason Momoa's guitar. Former vehicle of the day. Oh shit, my buddy Travis Simmons is retiring. Come by tomorrow for an interview. How about I'll eat a bag of fucking dicks, you schlepper? I don't need an interview for anything. That was the former vehicle of the day. Jason Momoa's surfboard.
Yeah.
Well, it's time for Jason Momoa as our hunk of the day.
And when you get a guy that wicked hardcore badass legend, you might want to bring out some hardcore.
How about a little bit of fucking heavy metal, people? The Trooper.
Iron Man. Yeah!
Because I know it's safe to play on Facebook and YouTube, and I've tested it. It says it's not safe to play, but I tested it and it is. Jason Momoa.
Yo, how do you get our bears on day for you? We can have the Shadow Saber today.
Do you realize he's fucking the shit out of Lisa Bonet? Lisa Bonet loved her in the comedy show. Loved her in the movie Angel High. Lisa Bonet gave me a boner!
And him too, obviously.
Now he's born 1979. Lisa Bonet was born November 16th, 1967. I'm going straight off of memory! Alright? Now it's time to be tested. Lisa Bonet! I said November 16, 1967. Let's see if I'm right.
I am.
I are smart.
I drink the air.
And I loved it when she showed her titties in Angel High in 1987. Fuck yeah, Lisa Bonet. She's 51 years old! Jason Momoa just turned 40 recently! Airborne August 1st, 1979! He's a MILF hunter!
And Lisa Bonet's a fucking MILF, baby! Yeah!
MILFHunter.com!
That's a legendary website if you like them older women. If you wonder. Been around for over 20 years. MILFHunter.com. Jason Momoa. For you, Tracy. For you, Sam. For all you ladies out there who love the men. For all you men out there who love the men. Prepare your Jason Momoa again. Because you people keep requesting him and I say, fuck it. Give the fans what they want. Without fans, the Love Doctor would never fucking show.
Oh my God, look at Lisa Bonet. Lisa Bonet, give me a motherfucking motor. There I go, ladies!
Rah! You like I'm rough and tough! You are rough and tough! You ain't got enough for me and my noodles! Not for damn sure! Yeah!
Whatever.
Jason Momoa. You're having a day. A parents are day. Free.
Yeah! There you go. And he's topless.
Hey! If men can go topless, why the fuck can't women go topless, right? Don't worry. On Beer Song Day, women do go topless. Because I believe in equality. Facebook doesn't like it, but Facebook can eat a big bag of motherfucking dicks. Okay? Am I sober? Actually, believe it or not, yes I am. I might have a very, very light buzz at best. It's freaking nuts. We need to bring out our next song. Eh?
Yeah.
I think it's time for some more rockabilly. Time for some more rockabilly? Yeah. Why not? We're gonna play. Oh no, we're gonna play fucking That's a Groovy Thing. Jimmy Covello. Now, Jimmy Covello was born March 14th, 1927. He's a Pennsylvania icon. He's a white guy with a saxophone that is 92 and still touring and still performing. In fact, I'm gonna show you a picture of him in a moment. Jason Momoa, your hunk of the day, right there. And Jimmy Covello and his House Rockers. That's a Groovy Thing, 1956. I'm gonna prove it to you. Jimmy Covello, Pennsylvania legend. On March 14th, 1927. Oh, from Syracuse, New York originally. He's living in Pennsylvania now, though.
I play sweet, I play sweet, I play hot, I play hot. When we swing, that's a groovy thing.
He's still doing it, baby.
I
thought it was in Pennsylvania, but
that's the groovy thing, Won't you listen to me? Aren't you ever to see?
They're all going strong, baby.
Be able to swing.
Jimmy Covello! Hell yeah, I love this fucking song! Woo, baby! And for those who are wondering, no! I do not take drugs, I'm high on life, baby! I am high on life! We're already 74 minutes into the show, and I ain't going anywhere because I got a lot of pictures of Olivia Munn to show.
Yeah, Barbie. All
right. What do I want to play next? Oh, yeah. How about some West Coast Rhythm and Blues for my favorite duo of all time, Barbie and Johnny, who are both still with us. Emery Perry was in the role of Johnny on this one. Marvin Phillips. Born October 23rd, 1931. He's still with us, thankfully. Almost 88 years old, still going strong. From June 10th, 1955, the day that former Major League Baseball pitcher Floyd Bannister was born, we bring Mamo Mamo, Specialty Records. Mamo Mamo, here you go. Oh, you're gonna love this one. Mamo! Mamo Mamo! Motherfucker! Yeah!
Mamo Mamo! Mamo Mamo! Mamo Mamo! Mamo Mamo!
season 5. And we hope when you're on a date, look them up yourselves.
That ain't a woman, that's a man right there.
It's not drink, motherfucker. I said let's all drink. Catch him a Momoa! You know those lovely lady goddesses over at Fire Lickers? Sam and Tracy!
Yeah, babies!
She's another Mary Jo. I love life and I love living it, baby! Jason Momoa! Mamo! Momoa! Momoa! Whatever the
fuck, I don't give a fuck.
I sure hunger is there, baby! Jason Momoa, motherfuckers! Yeah! Momoa! 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 Jason Momoa! 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 Motherfuckers! Oh yeah, he was in fucking Baywatch too, eh?
There you go. Sam and Tracy and all you folks that love Jason Momoa. He was in Baywatch. Yeah. Well, what do you know? In fucking Baywatch. Oh hell. She's resting her head on his boobies. I'd rest my head on her boobies. Which head? I don't give a fuck. Wouldn't rest my head on his boobies, though. Not my style. To each their own, though. Hey, if two dudes rub wieners together, who gives a shit? If they're happy and ain't bothering anybody, who gives a fuck? Stop judging, people. Stop judging. Judge not. In fact, Bob Marley had a song in February 1962 called Judge Not. I would play it, but I don't know if that's a good idea. So what I am gonna do is I'm gonna play some Massachusetts rockabilly. Rockatine, the Satellites from 1959. Oh, I love this song. I know you will too. Ooh yeah.
Rock a team,
listen to drumming. Radio Garage Rock 1959 in Winston, Nation, Massachusetts. But folks, while Massachusetts wouldn't be an American paradise, no motherfucking score. You're gonna say, had some dad bod going on. What are they? Epic badass motherfucker.
Rock-a-teen.
We're gonna bring out some great stuff for that hot day right there.
We've gone through our 100 days. Jason Momoa. The rest of the show is dedicated to our baby today, our baby's all day.
Olivia Munn, in honor of you, Jeff Bill.
Jeff Bill, I love you, brother. You're fucking looking awesome. Jeff Bell, we are at the 80-minute mark on Bears on Day. And Jeff Bell, it is time to unleash your fan request.
The Babe of the Day on Bears on the Day. We always say the best for last. Olivia Munn.
Ooh, yeah.
Jeff I love you, brother. And I'll see you back on Saturday. Saturday, tomorrow. Jeff, you don't ask for much. You're not that kind of person. You're the guy that's all about giving and not asking. I'm like that myself. I am. And that's why I always ask you guys, what do you guys want to hear? And Jeff, I know you love some Stevie Ray Vaughan. Texas Blues, Texas Icon, your favorite musician. Now, my personal favorite is my personal favorite, of course, is Chuck Berry. You and I have talked about music a lot. And Jeff Bell, if I'm going to bring out your David and Dave request for Beer and Song of the Day, I better bring out your favorite song of all time, even though it is not a wild, insane, up-tempo song. I think we need to just go ahead and relax, mellow out for a moment, and play your personal favorite song of them all. Life by the Drop, Stevie Ray Vaughan. So let's do that. And we'll play another Stevie Ray Vaughan song after set. Yeah. It's my show. I do what I want. Yeah, you're a baby today, Olivia Munn.
Hello there, my old friend. Not so long ago, it was still the end. Started over again.
Olivia Munn. Oh, yeah. Warning, there will be a few bare female movie mentions. So if you're easily offended, you might want to stop watching. Oh, my God. Jeff, I love you, brother. I'll see you, pappies.
Up and down that road, I don't want that shoes.
See through Jonas. Oh, Atari! Jeff, you and I remember those days. Yeah, we do. I like the red panties too, though. You got that right, Life by the Drop. The drop of beer? Down my gullet? Yeah. By the way, this beer is awesome. It's light, it's delicious. It definitely has great notes of coconut and pineapple. And I do give it a 4.25. It's a very good beer. I might end up giving that 4.5 because it actually got better as it warmed, which IPAs don't always do that, but it did. It just seemed to go down. You saw how fast I started drinking it, so that tells me that it was getting better and better. Oh, she rocks. Ooh, yeah. I know. I saw Kevin. Fuck yeah. All right. I'm going to actually call my good buddy Kevin Sherman, Heavy Metal and Blues. I haven't talked to him. I mean, we messaged each other back and forth. I might actually just call the guy and say, dude, fucking amazing. I'm going to tell you right now, I am going to go live at the Abilene Beer Summit on September 21st. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. All right. I think we need to play. All right. I need to fucking bring out something wild, fast. I gotta bring out something wild and I gotta bring it out fast. I haven't played enough doo-wop today. But I gotta play this one too. Purr Kitty Purr, said King of the Five Strings from 1955. Cause this is hot stuff right here. Listen to the lyrics on this one, people. Chung-ho! All right, Chun-Li, I know, but I want to make her into Chun-ho, okay? I got a joystick you can play with, sweetheart. Yeah, baby. I got a joystick you can play with there, Olivia Munn.
We both know the beat and it's better than paradise. You got a purr kitty, purr kitty, purr kitty, purr and swing.
Chewlocka Jolly. It's all about sex. The song was not released by a group called the Jumpin' Jacks. It's about time to bring out some doo-wop. Chewlocka Jolly, April 27, 1953, the Jumpin' Jacks. Here you go. I fucking love this song. I do. Olivia Munn, who's your papa? Chewlocka Jolly, I want it right away. Fuck you, Peter people. Listen to the lyrics. I'm gonna shut the fuck up and show off the eye again. Y'all understand what I'm talking about.
For my sweet sister. It was good. For my own brother.
Direct TV.
Chewlocka Jolly,
you like a daddy? Do you like a daddy?
Give me a little bit of that.
Do you like a daddy? I wanna ride away. It is good with the right tomato.
Titties!
It is good.
More titties! Ah! More titties! Woo yeah!
With the cardboard green. It is good. With the pendle bean.
I got some music, hey, Link. Hey, hey. Link with this bitch. Oh, dickhead!
Do like a daddy, give me a little bit. Do like a daddy, I want it right away.
For Chris only, he's not anymore.
Long about noon.
12 is when your celebrities get their pictures leaked.
The cool of the evening.
Oh, man. That's good.
Long about midnight. Hey, 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 give me love. Give me that too, like it, darling. Give me up, a bit of that too, like it, darling. Give me up, a bit of that too,
like it, darling.
Good lord, if that ain't really hot, I don't know what is. Holy moly, get out of my head.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, girl, I'll tell you, those famous 4chan stolen photos, yep, I'm showing them off. If anybody reports me for this show, fuck you. Alright, I'm just going to say that. That's all I'm going to say about that. To me, that's the good Lord's artwork. That is artwork right there. Olivia Munn. Oh, what a hun. She's definitely got it going on. She needs to love Dr.'s gun. And that ain't gonna happen, because I'm a good man. Jeff Bell, she wants your gun. That ain't gonna happen. You're a good man. Let's play one of the greatest records of all time. Sun Records number 192. From September 1953, we're going to play both sides. Mystery Train, followed by Love My Baby. Little Junior's Blue Flames, Little Junior Parker, born 1932, passed away much too young at the age of 39 in 1971. Mystery Train, Love My Baby. We're going to play both sides. Mystery Train. Original. Yeah, yeah. Give her the love train. And have her train your main vein, motherfuckers. Yeah.
Train our ride.
Oh!
Ooh,
yeah. Sun Records number 192. Recorded in Memphis, Tennessee, baby.
In my
1953.
Train, train.
Oh, yeah, you
just
saw that, yeah.
Tell me
to blow your horn. Yeah.
Train, train.
Going on. There you go, Jeff. 100 knees for you, brother. 100 knees again for Jeff Bill. Jeff is a good man. He's gonna pass up the guns he has.
Do it again.
Let's drink to Olivia Munn. She suffers from erectus nipulus.
Which is funny, because I suffer from erectus dicamus. And my lesbian friends suffer from erectus clitoris.
Shows that she shaves the landing strip.
Bringing my baby.
Oh, yeah, I got some you can lick. And my dick ain't sick. I'm a good boy. Jeff Pell. watch this whole show, you might have a fucking hat on by the time you do it. Maybe you could watch the other old Pepper Silver Brewing Company. You know? Because this is probably one of the most insane shows I've ever done. I've been doing my show since January 17th, 2012, the day that Betty White turned 90 years old. She was the first ever celebrity birthday I mentioned on my show. Therefore, every year on my anniversary show, she's always a baby of the day on my show. And we're going to flip the record over now. Sun Records number 192. Love My Baby. Wild fucking song. Listen to that. Yeah! I know that. I love that picture too. That's going to end up in the beer song. I'm telling you. Hell yeah, lollipop, you just suck on a kid.
Love my baby, keeps our business to herself. Well, our friends don't know it, don't need nobody else. Sweet little thing, sweet as you. Sweet little thing, sweet as you ever seen. Well, make a man, she can be so mean.
We've gone through 100 pictures. 93 pieces. We got 100 to go for Olivia Munn. Yo, baby, I'm drinking it.
Oh yeah.
Always full play, motherfuckers.
1 and 1 is 2, 2 and 2 is 4.
Oh!
Ooh! I love you,
baby. There you go, Jeff Bell, motherfucker!
I love you, brother.
Let's show that picture off a little bigger. Yeah. Shaven, not stirred. Time to get it real dirty. I think it's time to get it a little bit extra dirty. I think. That was the intent. Problem is, I forgot what song I was going to play next. Okay. This song's so bad, I can't play it on Facebook, I can play it on YouTube. And this song's all about sex. It requires the dickhead hat for this one. Yeah. All I'm gonna do is show off the hottie, and I'm gonna go ahead and let you listen to the lyrics. The song's called Ride Daddy Ride. By a man named Fats Noel. From 1951, the song was released in 1952. And I fucked up. I'm not sober anymore. I just realized that. My nerve damage that I have is starting to take effect. So, here you go. Oh. Come on, fuckface. Really?
There it is! Ron Denny died! Fast the Will! 1951!
Yeah! I got a little girl, she loves to ride. I got a little baby, she loves to ride. When I see that woman, I got to run in my eyes. She loves to ride all night, ride all day. She wants to ride all night, ride all day. Baby, this is all she said.
Dirty now at this point, because I don't give a fuck. I'd give her a fucking mouth single request though. Yeah. Alright. Hell with it. Let's go all the way dirty, baby. All the way fucking dirty. Yeah. Oh boy. I can't believe I'm going to do this, but I know it's safe to play. Believe it or not, this is actually safe to play on the old Facebook. And YouTube. Yep, it is. So let's do it. Wow. This has been a show for the ages, people. This is rare. I don't normally go this balls to the wall, but I don't give a fuck. I'd give her a fuck about a single, of course. How about anal sex? David Allan Coe, 1982. And that's right, Jeff Bell. Your son Jared got to hang out with David Allan Coe, who's now 80 years old. He looked a little rough, but by God, he's still going.
I like to fuck the shit out.
So would everybody else. Everybody wants to fuck the shit out of Olivia Moon.
Fuck the shit out of you. Like to fuck the shit out.
Sit down here, you out
of Texas. Howdy. Baby, won't you give me some head? Hey, baby, won't you give me some head? Baby, won't you give me some head? Baby, won't you give me some head?
Yeah! Oh, Clay Vaughn is friends with Clay. She's a gamer, and a gamer.
We like to eat lunch down at the Y. We like to eat lunch.
She's a gamer, and I got games I play with.
We like to eat lunch down at the Y.
Why?
Because we love you. Hi, I'm David, and these are my friends.
We've enjoyed doing this album for you. We'd like to especially dedicate this album to all the members of the Mickey Mouse fan club, and also to you, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are. And I'd like to
fuck the shit out of you. I'd like to fuck the shit out of you. I'd like to fuck the shit out of you. I'd like to fuck the shit out of you.
Cleavage, French for cleavage. Where are we sitting at? We got 24 more pictures of this lovely goddess. Our baby today on Birdsong Day. Fucking A. What have I not played enough of today? Aha! Big 10-inch record. Well, you know Ron Jeremy, porn star, had a big 10-inch dick, so they say. I don't know. I don't want to know. But one of our owners over at Vinyl Liquors recommended having Ron Jeremy as a hug in a day. So we're going to do it. We've done it before. It's been a long time. So in honor of Ron Jeremy and those big dick bastards out there with a 10-inch dick, we bring out big 10-inch record. The original version of Big 10-inch record. Benjamin Bull Moose Jackson. Released in December 1952. And he's a sax-blasting badass motherfucker. The original!
God being strange as woman. Believe me, this shit.
The original version.
But I really get her going when I take out my Big 10-inch. Record of the band that plays the blues.
Brian says he did a very popular version of the song.
She just loves my big 10-inch. Record of her
blues. That's the original version. Benjamin Bull Moose Jackson. Moosey was born in 1919, passed away in 1989 at the age of 70. Benjamin Bull Moose Jackson. I love this guy.
I gave her a little pinch, but she said, now stop that jiving and get out that big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues.
Oh, yeah.
Plays the blues. She did love my big 10-inch record of her favorite blues. I cover her with kisses when we're in a lover's clinch. And she begs for my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
She just loves that
big 10-inch,
my favorite blues. Don't go for smoking, and liquor just makes her flinch. See, she just goes for nothing, except my big 10-inch record of the band that plays the blues. Well, the band that plays the blues.
This is gonna be my final song.
She just loves my big 10-inch record of her favorite blues.
In my opinion, this is all time, possibly top 10 episode of Birdsong Day. I've recorded over 1,500 episodes of Birdsong Day. YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, all kinds of shit. I will never be able to know the official number of shows I've recorded. But I will tell you this. I've had a lot of fun doing what I do, and I'm going to keep doing it until the day I fucking drop dead. That's our final picture of our baby today. And we have had an incredible show. It's probably not for the kids. I don't believe in censorship, so I don't give a shit. I thought my name was son of a bitch and motherfucker growing up. I knew that even though my parents swore religiously, I knew you don't swear in front of your parents, which is something that I still don't do to this day out of fucking respect. Out of respect, I don't swear in my parents' home. Now, hey, you know, we'll swear a little bit, but my brother and sister, they're a little worse than I am, but anyway, it is what it is. But folks, this has been an incredible show. It's been a lot of fun. 111 minutes. By the time it's done, it'll be 113. But I have got to put my stupid ass to bed because I have got to wake up for work in 5 hours. I gotta be at work in 6.5 hours. So folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make the fetus the head out. So everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything when due. Don't do I told you I always say peace be the journey. I wasn't kidding. Peace be the journey. See, it's on the can. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything when due. Don't drink and drive. It might spill your drink. I might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that is being a fan of Justine. Ow. I hate to be wild. Become such a little douchebag, 12 off a waste of a sperm egg. No shit, y'all, you little bitch. Beaver. And she probably has one of those too, just saying. But you know what's dumber than that, though? It's men's appointment. Or animal abuse, or racism, or people who watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody who supports and friends with a member of the Westboro Baptist Church, or ISIS, or the fucking Facebook police. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big, fat, whoppow GFA shoved up there. Rudy Poo-Cat, yes. Folks, I'm out of here. My next show will be my first Football Sunday show since the Super Bowl. Football Sunday, I think I'm going to record it and then share it onto YouTube and Facebook. It depends on which game I choose as the game of the week. I did see that the Packers beat the Bears. And I was wrong on my prediction. I picked the Bears to win, and I was wrong on that. It was a defensive struggle. 10-3, final score. That might be my game of the week. I haven't decided yet, and I have to look through the rest of the games to determine. But anyway, if the Packers and Bears are my game of the week, I'll record on YouTube because there will be some Bear female boobies. So, yeah. But I'm out of here. I will see you all soon. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Fuck yeah. 114 plus minutes. Wow, what a show this was. I can't believe I have this much energy. Holy fuck. Not for the kids.